Because in this video, we are going to see if you insert command, how to insert a record in a table. So the general syntax of this insert is, this is what the insert command, insert into table name, then in which column, which value. So this is attached with this value, first column to this value, first second column to this value, and so on. So insert into table name within bracket column names values for the respective columns. In this case, it is, if you follow this method, then you can give like this. See, for example, insert into st table student id and student name values 200 Jayanti. So this 200 will go for this and Jayanti will go for this. Here we have left other columns. Okay, in this case it will not, because as those two columns are they are not null, they are not defined as not null, so it allows blank data on that. Okay, so here, and you can change this also, student name first and student ID, but if you change this also has to be changed as first Jayanti and 200. So the order can be changed, but you have to be careful in giving the data for the correct column. It is up to the programmer, or else it will allocate the value, provided if both the data types are same, it happens that it will allow the data. Say for example, this student ID is also integer, and if you enter an age, that also it will accept. So we have to be careful while giving the data, correct data. So for example, the next example, insert into student table, student ID, age, student name, department. Here we have changed the order of occurrence of the table column name, but you have to be careful while giving the data. So for student ID, we have given 200, age 24, student name Jayanti, and department ID 84. You should not change this. If you change this, here also you have to change. So it will, because the first one matches with the first one of these values, same way. So you have to be careful. You can change the order in the column, but you have to change accordingly the values assigned also. Then another syntax is insert into table name values. So like this, so insert into student name values like this. Here, this is applicable only if you don't change the order, because here we are not giving any column name. So it is strictly that you have to give the correct order. How you have created your column name in table, the same order you have to give. So this is the restrictions. So there are three types you can give. One is insert into table name, then you have to give column names, and then respective values. You can change the column names, but your care has to be taken in giving the values. Then here, without column name also you can give, but you must give the values in strict order of the occurrence of the columns. Now we'll go to phpMyAdmin, and then we'll see how we can enter data. Already we have created a database called test1, and then we have created a table called table one, and these are all the fields in that: roll number, name, mark one, mark two, etc. Okay, now this is the column headings. Now we want to insert. How to insert here? So for what I have given is how you can insert in a terminal, but we are going to use the PHP MyAdmin only. So how we have gone inside? By opening the XAMPP control, then pressing this, and then next to the MySQL, we have this admin. You press that, now it will take you there. Or else you can directly type this command, that is localhost slash phpMyAdmin in the browser as URL. So now you will be in the screen. Now already we have created the table, okay, test one. So when under the test one, we have created the table one. I'll show that. Now table one has the following column. So you can expand this. See here, has come. So it show you the columns. Now we are going to enter the data, that is insert record. So how to do that? Through this you can insert. Here is an insert command, or through SQL also you can insert. Now just now I have given you the insert command. We'll try that. Then we'll go here with the interface. Now I want to insert. So how I can do? See here. select star is for all, select, if you select this, it will select the particular columns, then insert. Insert is to insert the data. Since there is no data in our table, I'm going to insert new data, and it is for update, delete, etc. Now we'll first we'll do insert. See, automatically it will give the value, normal syntax. Insert into table one, all these things are displayed, column names, values. Now I can give value here directly. Let's try to remove this. Okay, now for name, I'm giving Anita. Since it is a worker, I give it within the quotes, and then role number. Role number is not a, so I give integer. Then mark is also an integer. So let me give like this. Okay. Now I have to execute this statement. Then only the data will be inserted. So I have to give this go. Yes, see here, one row inserted. Now one data is inserted. This is nothing but the data. Now if I want to see, I can see that. See here, Anita 189.90. So if you press browse, you can see the data. Now I want to insert more data. So in the case, now I already told you how to do that, but let me do it with this insert. Now it will open up like an interface. So here I can directly type the data. So now I have to press go. Okay, so now this data is there. Now you just press go. Whatever the data is entered in this SQL, now you have to press go in order to execute that. Now another data is also inserted. Now you can see your data here. See, two times entered. That is because we have entered go. No need for that. Again, I press insert. No need to press this go. Okay, already one row is inserted. Now if I want to change, I can change it, because already this data is inserted. Here we get the table. If I give again go, it will double entry. So now I am just changing this. And then I press go. Now I browse. See here, Banu Bama. Here it is coming, because there also I have pressed again go. That is why the data is duplicated. But I want to avoid this duplication. So in that case, how I can do that? Only thing is I have to delete it and make it as a primary key. Okay. So how to do that? So first, before that, we will remove this. So roll number equal to 101. Let me remove that data. So how to remove that? I can press this, because it's a duplication, where roll number is equal to 101. Now I'm going to execute. So delete from the table name where condition roll number, the roll number is equal to 101. We want to remove it. Yes, okay. Error. Okay, what is the error? Have an error. So to use near equal to 101. So it's giving me the suggestion also. So I am not supposed to use double equal to. So let me give that. Yes, it is removed. Now we'll see. Yes, both data is removed. Now I don't want this situation to happen, because when I remove that, both the data is, I want to keep one and I want to remove another one. But there is no criteria which will identify individually. That is why I'm not able to keep both, because in both name column, roll number column, mark one, mark two, everything is same. So I can't keep one and I can't remove another one. So in that case, I have removed both. So I don't want this situation to happen again. So what I have to do, I have to make one as an unique key. So how to do that? So now I go to the structure. I can change anything at any time. I can change. So now I want to make this roll number as a primary key. So I select only roll number. Then I have to make this as a primary key. Structure. Yes, here. I'm sorry, I have gone here. Instead of that, you select the roll number and select it and make it as a primary key. Do you really want to execute altered table? Add primary. Okay. So now see here, there is a key coming near this roll number. Now this has become the primary key. Now I am trying to insert. We'll see. Okay, now the same data I'm trying to enter. Let me give 105. Okay, now it is already inserted. Now I'm trying to insert this, execute this query again. Already this is inserted through this interface. Now I can write a query also. So say for example, I am writing something else, not Aswini, some other name, AA, with the same roll number. Now we see what it is giving me. Error. Because, see here, duplicate entry. Because now, just now I have made this as a primary key. When you make it as a primary key, you cannot enter more than, that is, duplication is not allowed. You will not be allowed to enter. So instead, now I change this to 106. Okay, now it allows. Yes, one row inserted. When I see that, see here. Anita, Bonu, Bama, Shini. Yes, now it is displayed. Allowed. So unique. I cannot again enter a roll number with 103 because already Bonu is having 103. So this is how you insert data. So through SQL also you can insert through that interface, insert. This also you can insert and you can at any time you can modify your columns. But that is not a good practice to do. So while designing itself, you decide which is the primary key and assign, make that as a primary key. So for that, that is what we call as integrity. So you have to maintain the integrity of the database. So duplication should be avoided. So these are how you can insert data through the interface, okay? And you can delete the data using the SQL query commands. We can select this and you can remove a particular row, as well as you can update. We'll see how we can update. See, update, then table one. Table one is the name of the table, and set, this is a keyword, update, table name, set, which column I want to modify, the data which I want to modify. So here it automatically, this update will give all the name of the columns, and left and right hand side we have to modify the data. So now I want to modify the one with the, okay. Now if you see that, I want to change this name with the roll number 106. So first we have to say which data we want to change. So the roll number 106 name I want to change. So now we'll go here, SQL update. When I give update, it will give all the columns, but I don't want to change all the columns. I want to change only the name value. So now I give the value, the name as Rajan, and whose roll number, set name equal to. So let me remove all these things. I want to change only the name, where roll number is equal to 106. Yes, I want to make the name AAA to Rajan, whose roll number is 106. So this is how you modify. Now I just press go. What happened? Update table one, there is a syntax error. This comma should be removed. Okay, now I execute it again. Yes, now it has worked. So the syntax correction is no comma, because only one column is there. So no need to give comma. So update table one, set which column I want to change. That follows the set and equal to what the new value, and then where roll number equal to 106. This is how you modify, you update an existing data. So now when I browse, see here, this 106 AAA is changed with Rajan. So this is how you modify, you make changes, you manipulate data in PHP MyAdmin.